Brian C., your Marion County Extension agent, and today we're going to calibrate this sprayer. Now I got a co-host, Rusty. Say hi, Rusty. That's it. Okay, so the first thing you want to do when you're calibrating your sprayer is you want to measure the width of the spray pattern. So this sprayer is a cluster nozzle, has the extended type nozzles on it. So we're going to start the tractor up. You want to rev the tractor up to the RPMs that you're going to be running in the field and have your pressure set to the proper setting. And with these type nozzles, 40 PSI is plenty. So I'm going to start the tractor up, run it up to the RPMs, turn the PTO on, and then put these flags out on the edges of the spray pattern. And then we're going to measure the spray pattern, and then we're going to get that measurement, and we'll plug it into a formula, and then we'll go to the next step. You'll notice it's not spraying as far on this one side. That's because I don't have the pressure adjusted just right yet. You would want to get that set correctly, obviously, but before you calibrate. But I'm kind of new to the sprayer, so I'm getting it fixed up and wanted to get this done before we lose daylight. So we measured our spray width pattern. It was 30 feet wide. So we divide 5,460 by 30, that gives us 182 feet. So we're going to lay out a course 182 feet long, and we're going to drive the tractor on that course, and we're going to record the time that it takes to drive that the course. And then we'll go to the next step from there. So now I'm going to set up the course, drive the tractor through the course. And it's important to drive the tractor the speed that you'll be driving in the field. So if 4 miles per hour is what you're comfortable with, drive it that. If it's 3, drive it that. If it's 6 or 7, you know, drive it that. But just drive the course and record the time and go the speed that you will in the field. So I'm going to set up the course and record the time that it takes to drive it, and we'll move on to the next step. Okay, so I've laid out the course, and now I'm going to drive the tractor through the course and time myself. I also want to mention that it's important that you are up to speed whenever you hit this first flag on the course. So you don't want to come up to this flag at a dead stop and then take off and time it. So you want to come, I'm going to come around here, and by the time my front tire hits this flag, I'll be up to speed. And then I'm going to start the time, see how long it takes me to reach the other flag. So I'm going to do that now. Okay, so I drove the course and it took 26 seconds. Just to kind of double check yourself, you can run the course a couple times. I actually timed myself going that way, and then I restarted the time coming back this way, and it averaged to 26. So what we're going to do now is we're going to get set up and we're going to turn on the sprayer and catch water for 26 seconds. Two different nozzles, one for each side. we're just going to catch on one side and then multiply that by two to get our total gallons per acre that we're putting out. So we're going to catch water for 26 seconds and then we're going to measure it out in pints, and however many pints we've caught, that'll be how many gallons per acre that we're applying to the field. So I'm going to start the tractor and we'll get that done. Measure this out. There's 4 cups or 2 pints. So if we multiply that by 2, we've got a nozzle shooting on either side. That would be 10 gallons per acre. Okay, so last time we left off, we had 10 gallons per acre, and that just didn't seem right. Usually these sprayers are putting out about 20 gallons per acre or so. And so I looked into it, and I mean, this is real world stuff, folks. The valve wasn't opened all the way going to the spray nozzles, so it was reducing our pressure, and it just wasn't outputting as much water as it could. So what does that mean? We get to do it all over again. So, you know, that's what it takes when you're calibrating sprayers, trial and error. So what I'm gonna do is measure the spray width of the sprayer, spray pattern width. I also have some new co-hosts, some cows that are coming in here. But anyway, and then we're going to do the math and measure out our course, drive the course, time ourselves, and then we're going to catch water. And then we're going to see how much water we're putting out per acre. So you sit tight and watch, and we're gonna get that done again. Here we go. On average. So we're going to set up and catch water out of the sprayer on one side for 34 seconds, and then we'll measure that and double it, so we'll have the output of both sides, and then we'll know hopefully how many gallons per acre we're putting out. Will tell us how many gallons per acre we're putting out. just one side of the sprayer. So to account for both nozzles, you double that, and we're putting out about 16 gallons per acre. So you can see now that we've upped the pressure, got the valve all the way open, and we're getting a lot more of the water flow through. I'm moving along pretty good, actually. I don't know how many miles per hour I'm going, but I just know my gear and RPM. So I'm going to say that 16 gallons per acre is going to be good. We're going to go with that. I'd like to thank Crooked Creek Conservation for the use of their sprayer. I'm the first one to use it this year. They had it in storage, and so that's, you know, anytime you get a piece of equipment out for its first use of the year, you know, there's always something that you'd have to tinker with, but this is a good piece of equipment. I think they ran it. This is a 300 gallon sprayer for $25 a day, so you can't beat that deal. They also have another sprayer. I think it's a 500 gallon, so check them out. We'll post up their phone number, and they're here in Marion County, Crooked Creek Conservation District. So thanks to them for the use of the sprayer. So if you have any questions about calibrating your sprayer, just give us a call at the Extension office here in Marion County. And thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.